This video will explain how we can use positive and negative numbers to describe temperature and elevation. During parts of the video, you will be asked to pause and think about or write down the answers to one or more questions. Doing this will help you to clear up any misunderstandings you may have had as you hear the explanation. Your teacher may have included a student note-taking sheet for you to use to record your work, or you may choose to use a piece of paper as you work through the lesson. Remember, you may pause to complete problems at any time or revisit any parts of the screencast throughout the week if you need them to complete your independent work. During this warm-up, I'm going to show you an image. Your job is to think of at least one thing you notice and one thing you wonder. When you are ready, resume the video. You may have noticed that the temperatures have different letters. You may have noticed that the times are different. It's 5 o'clock in Memphis, Tennessee, and it's 6 o'clock in Bangor, Maine. You may have noticed that there is a minus sign on one of the temperatures. You may have wondered what the two temperatures mean. Why isn't it snowing in the colder city? And what does a minus sign mean? Let's take a closer look. We have rainy conditions in Memphis, Tennessee, and we have partly cloudy conditions in Bangor, Maine. In both places, there is a Fahrenheit and Celsius temperature. In one, the Fahrenheit is positive and so is the Celsius. In the other, the Fahrenheit is positive, but the Celsius scale is negative. That makes me wonder why that is the case. I can assume that these are the same temperatures, but they are written in both the Fahrenheit and Celsius scale. In the US, temperatures are usually measured in either degrees Fahrenheit, which is what you may be most familiar with, or degrees Celsius. Many other countries measure temperature in degrees Celsius, and scientists use this temperature scale. One thing that is special about the Celsius scale is that when you are at sea level, water freezes at 0 degrees and boils at 100 degrees. For today's lesson, we want to be able to explain what zero, positive numbers, and negative numbers mean in the context of temperature and elevation. We want to be able to use positive and negative numbers to describe temperature and elevation. And we want to know what positive and negative numbers are.